I told Chan I was going to steal his sack dance, but I don't know.
I mean, you're a teammate, so that's okay.
Yeah, but that's like his trademark, man. You know, he does it every time. So I don't know. I might have to go on YouTube or something.
So I noticed your Twitter handle is Came a Long Way. Just what does that phrase signify to you? Why did you decide to make that your account?
It's just a small testament of my journey to get to where I am now. Starting back in high school, I was a late bloomer. I didn't play Little League, Pop Warner, anything. I didn't start playing football until my freshman year in high school. And my first practice, I didn't even know how to put on shoulder pads or where to put the, that was back then before they had the padded girdles. So that was when you actually had to put your hip pads, knee and thigh pads in. So I had to have somebody help me do it because I had never played organized sports up until that point. So I was considered a late bloomer. Went through my high school career, very little exposure. My whole football career, I've been doubted. People have always said, we don't think he's good enough to do this, or we don't think he's good enough to do that. Even up until this day, you know, like, people are surprised that I'm doing as well as I am. You know, like, when I got drafted, everybody said I'd just be a core special teamer until I was able to figure things out. And here I am, 5 years in, and I've been a starter since day one.
So going through all of that journey, finally making it to the NFL, a rookie playing in the Super Bowl, what was just that experience like, and how has that just shaped the player that you are today?
It just shows that there's no stage too big, you know? Like, I played in the biggest game you can possibly play in as a football player, you know, the Super Bowl. So at this point in my career, there's nothing that I feel like I can't do. I've done it all.
Well, you've certainly made yourself at home in this defense on the field, but what about off the field? What has this offseason just been like for you being a newcomer and trying to make this place feel a little bit more like home?
Oh, it definitely was a little bit different. It was kind of an easy decision to come here. And, you know, just after talking to VJ and talking to Cliff and Billy, it really made me feel comfortable and just getting outside opinions from other resources. You know, it seemed like a great opportunity. You got a young coach who has players who have a lot of confidence in him. And I feel like that's important, because if you don't believe in your coaching staff, then you won't go out and play the type of football that you know you're capable of playing. So that's important, man. Like, when players don't believe in coaches, things can go bad really quick. And, you know, I just felt confident in my decision. And I know we have a lot of great players on this team, and we can accomplish a lot, but we just have to take it one day at a time.
Well, another little connection with the Cardinals. Your first career pick was actually off Carson Palmer, Arizona Cardinals.
Right? Yep, my rookie year. That was before I got LASIK eye surgery, so I could barely see the ball when it was coming my way, but I still managed to catch it.
Kingsbury has called you the X factor for this defense. What does that mean to you, just knowing the impact that you've made already?
It just makes me feel good to know that I'm somewhere where they appreciate me. They want me to be here, and I can contribute to wins on this team. And that was the first thing I said back in March. You know, like, I'm willing to come in and do whatever is asked of me. You know, like, I'm not a cocky person. I'm actually very quiet, and I just like to do what's asked of me. You know, whatever my role was, I was willing to embrace it and make the most of it.
But Vance Joseph did ask you to help Hicks out, alleviate some of the vocal responsibilities. How is that relationship just growing between the two of you?
Man, me and Jordan have a great relationship. You know, at this point, like, it's like I've known him my whole life. You know, we're laughing and joking, making jokes with each other. So it's pretty cool to come in and develop such a great relationship so quick, considering that, you know, we haven't had a lot of time together. Like, it's been, what, a month and a half, 2 months now that we've been together. We've lost a lot of time, but for us to click the way we're clicking so quickly, it's actually a bright spot, you know? It's a bright spot to look at, you know, two veteran players being able to mesh together and bring each other along. You know, like, that was one of the first things me and Jordan talked about, man. We're in this together. Like, we want to be the best in the league, and it starts with us.
You're an important part of this revamped defense during this offseason. One of three guys coming in this front seven to really make an impact. What is the potential for this defense, especially you knowing what it takes to make it to the Super Bowl caliber level for a unit?
One thing I know about our defense is we, like, when we're playing well, like, we don't have any weaknesses. And, you know, like, that's hard to do in this league, is have a complete defense all the way across the board. Like, when you look at our defense, we really don't have any holes. You know, like, I played on defenses where it was like, we're really good here, but, you know, we're not as good in this area. Or we're really good here and we're not as good in this area. And I don't really see that on this team. Like, we have the players to make it happen, but it's all on us. We have to take it one day at a time and handle our responsibilities. That's the beautiful thing about this league and about the game of football. Nothing is promised. You only get what you earn.
Last question. I know you said you're a quiet guy, but you've seen kind of the swag from Chandler Jones after a sack, from Peters with the slow-mo shimmy.
Yep.
When you get a sack, what are you going to do?
I don't know yet. I've actually been thinking about it. Like, I'm trying to figure out. I told Chan I was going to steal his sack dance, but I don't know.
I mean, you're a teammate, so that's okay.
Yeah, but that's like his trademark, man. You know, he does it every time. So I don't know. I might have to go on YouTube or something.
A lot of pressure.
Still a sack dance.
All right, well, we look forward to it. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.